Hello, everybody. Welcome to another miscellaneous pickups video. Last time I did it was a long time ago. Half a year, I think. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Now, I'm going to show you several games and movies. Old and new. Retro and new. For a variety of systems. Now, some of them I bought, there are a few months since I bought them, and well, if you follow me on Instagram, you already know that because I usually post almost everything there. But regardless, I'm going to show you everything here now. If I have shown before any of them on YouTube, I apologize, I'm probably forgot about the video. Anyway. Let's start with a movie, a Blu-ray movie. Dead or Alive. The movie based on the game, kind of. And it is basically an action film with lots of fighting and lots of good-looking women. And men, I guess. If that's your thing, it's in there. What can I say about this movie? I know it was blasted, but I don't care, as usual. I thought it was a fun movie to watch, and which is why I bought it on Blu-ray too. Yeah. Second, a game for the PlayStation 3. Medal of Honor Airborne. Perhaps my favorite Medal of Honor game. I already have it on PC through Steam. And I bought it years ago. And I have it on my Xbox 360, which I bought the game in 2008, I believe. Was it around the release of the game? Yeah, something like that. It was when I bought my second Xbox 360, the Elite, the black one. Now, the game is a terrific shoot-'em-up with randomization and upgrade options for your weapons. And depends on what you use, you can upgrade it as long as you keep using it. And you have the choice every time you start a level. After you die or something. Well, at the beginning at least. You need to play it to experience the whole thing. You choose where to land because you are airborne. Fantastic game. One of my favorite shoot-em-up games of all time. Not shoot-em-up. First-person shooters of all time. On any platform. As I said, I played it on the Xbox 360, PS3. I played the demo, I think. Haven't played this yet on the PlayStation 3, but I think I played the demo and on PC, and they're just amazing game on all of them. The other thing I have here is a movie, Blu-ray, Cutthroat Island. Another movie which I found myself reading and watching videos about it from people who blast this as a very bad movie or boring or something stupid. In my opinion, this is one of the best pirate movies ever. I don't know what people who blast this are talking about. They're either crazy, stupid, or haven't seen it. That's my view on them. Now, we continue with another game. This time for the Atari ST. A game I used to have. On the Atari ST. I played it, although I wasn't any good at it. But yeah, enough talking. Elite 2 Frontier, or Frontier Elite 2 for the Atari ST. Fantastic game, one of the best games ever on any platform, of course. Although I have played it only on the Atari ST, and I think I played it on the Amiga. Yeah. Compatible with 520 ST, STE, 1040 ST, STE, well, obviously, Mega ST and Mega STE. 1 megabyte RAM minimum. So if you have a 520 or, you need at least the upgraded memory to play this. Says joystick optional, and from what I remember, you could easily play it with a mouse. Yeah, fantastic game. Perhaps the best Elite game. Now, the next game is again for the Atari ST. A game which I didn't like when it first came out on any platform. Partly, I guess, because on the Atari ST was several discs, four, and you had to constantly swap them. Even though I had two drives, it was a pain. I didn't have a hard drive for my Atari ST. I would say this is one of the best games, although I still don't like it as much as I like the sequels. Still, I had to have it. Civilization by Microprose. What a company. And Sid Meier, when he used to still make games. Running out of room here. The next game. Another Atari ST game. Although it was too released on several other platforms. I know it was released on PC. Don't know if it was released on Amiga. Sometimes strategy games weren't always released on the Amiga. I played it a bit, not as much as the first game. This is a sequel. Even though this game was definitely much more complicated, it was a 4X on land. And the game is UMS2. Nations at War. A very complicated and quite surprised I did something as big as this on the 16-bit era. Fantastic game. Very difficult. And please, if you want to play this game, read the manual. You're gonna need it. Next game. For the Atari ST. This game was one of my favorite games on the console, on the system, and it is, in my opinion, one of the best games ever on any platform. Are you ready for this? Millennium 2.2 for the Atari ST. This is a strategy game where you are in control of the last best hope for humanity to survive. In the future, in the 22nd century, you are left in control of the colony on the moon. What happened on Earth? Well, shit hit the fan. The Earth is no longer habitable, and you have to expand humanity as much as possible and hopefully eventually go back to Earth. You are not alone. Fantastic game. Strategy game with action sequences. Next game. Next game is another Atari ST game. A game which you can play in two ways. One, as a first person or third person action game or simulator, if you like, or we can play the entire game from a map. And that's what I did. M1 Tank Platoon by Microprose, again, one of the best games of its generation. You're in control of a platoon of M1, A1, or A2. I assume it's A1 because A2 didn't arrive till the 90s. Yeah. And some support vehicles depending on the mission. The support vehicles, which can be IFVs or APCs or planes like A-10s or helicopters. If I remember correctly, the helicopters were the best as support vehicles. And you could play it either, as I said, a combat simulator, a tank simulator from first person view. You could change position, a gunner, driver, commander, not loader, things, I think. And or you could play it from the map view as a tactical real-time strategy game. And that's what I did, as I said, because I found the controls in first-person view not as good, partly because of the frame rate and partly because I sucked at it. But in general, this is one of the best games ever. No question about it. Next game. A game which I remember buying in 1995, I believe. Pretty sure it was 95. I'm 100% sure it was 95 when I bought it. Star Trek The Next Generation Final Unity. This game is a point-and-click adventure set in the TNG period. You are in control of the USS Enterprise and, of course, the crew, the major crew. And you have several missions to complete with an overall arc, and it's a fantastic adventure game. I used to have this and I lost it. A year or two ago, I found the disc and the manual and bought them, but I wanted to get the box and I couldn't find the box on its own, so I had to buy the whole thing. I don't mind because I paid like, I don't know, 5-6 euros or something, which is ridiculous. This is a very good PC game. I don't think it was released on any console. I doubt it was, because it was quite high resolution for the time. I have very good feelings, memories with this game. And it's one of the better Star Trek games ever. If you find it, buy it. At least if you like Star Trek and adventure games. Or adventure games. Because it is good as an adventure game on its own. But it definitely is a great game if you also like Star Trek. And I love Star Trek. And if you don't like Star Trek, I don't care. Star Trek rules. Okay. Next item. This one actually I bought several months ago for, I don't remember how much, I think like 19 euros. New. Something, yeah, I think 19. PlayStation TV. Yes, new. 19 euros. From one of the stores here. I don't particularly plan on playing it, as I have my PS Vita, which I like very much. But I want to get one, just in case I want to get one later on, and they are very hard to find, which is quite possible, believe it or not. Next one. For the PlayStation 4, custom an orange kind of faceplate, because as some of you might know, orange is perhaps my favorite color. So, well, almost my favorite color. It doesn't matter. Next game, yeah. For the Atari ST again. A game I never owned, at least in the physical form. Legal copy, let's go with that. Till now. Lotus Esprit, whatever. Outrun. Challenge, yeah. Anyway, you know the game. Lotus, as we mostly call it. The first one. My favorite from the trilogy. Two is good. Three is very good. But one is definitely my favorite. What a game for the Atari ST. Also on several other platforms, or at least the Amiga, I know that for sure, which was also very good. Yeah. Anyway, let's continue. Now this, for a change, this is an old game which I have never played before. But I read about it and appears to be a fantastic little game. Well, not little, old game, but very, very complicated. This is Mega Fortress Mega Pack. This is a quite rare version on CD, or else you would, when it was originally released, you could get it on floppy disks. Basically, you have control over a B-52 Mega Fortress, as it is called in this game. And you have missions in the Persian Gulf and against the USSR during the Cold War. What can I say about this game? Well, only what I have read. And what I have read is it's a very complicated flight simulator worth playing. This includes the mission disc, Operation Sledgehammer, which includes 25 extra missions against Iran and Libya. Good. I'm a sucker for good flight simulators. Next game. This is a PlayStation 3 game. And I haven't mentioned it, but all of these games I bought at stupidly low prices. And I like that. Another new game. And new as in condition. It was released several years ago. Socom 4 for the PlayStation 3. A tactical shooter. Never played any of these games of the series, but I've heard that they are very good, and this is very good. And believe it or not, it's not easy to find. At least at low price and new. Now, this game I wanted to get for several years for the PlayStation 3. I never got it because I wanted to get it at a low price because JRPGs are not my thing. However, as I see them not being available very often anymore, at least new, and the price is slightly going up, I decided to get this at a fantastic offer I got for like 15 euros or something. No, 12, I think. Yeah, anyway, something like that. New, again. Star Ocean, The Last Hope International. Which is Star Ocean, The Last Hope, on the PlayStation 3, which is updated with better graphics, better cutscenes, I think, and more DLC, not DLC, but more things in general, compared to the Xbox 360 version. Last Hope International. Star Ocean, yeah. There is a sequel out, or at least I don't know if it's a sequel or just another game in the series, which is unrelated to the first, I don't know. On the PlayStation 4 and perhaps Xbox One, it was released last year, I believe. Haven't played it. I want to play this one first. Now, this one is a game which I had to get it. A PlayStation 4 game. I think it's an exclusive. It is impossible to find here in Europe, new. At least I couldn't find it. So I had to get it from the States. Still, I bought it at ridiculously low price, so I'm happy with that. The game is Song of the Deep, where you control a submarine. Action-adventure type, I guess. I've seen videos of it, and I'm a sucker for submarines or anything with Navy ships. So I had to get it. We'll see if it's any good. Two last items. The first one is a strategy game for the PC. A game quite similar in ways to Civilization series. But it is definitely better in visuals, at least at the time. And also, it had the limitation of playing only in certain period of time, that is the ancient time. Unlike Civilization, of course, which forced you to play from ancient time till now. Although I believe in the later games, I haven't tried it. You can set it to start later on, I don't remember. Anyway, I used to have this game, but over the years I lost it. Here it is. The Rise and Rules of Ancient Empires by Sierra. This is, again, boxed, big box version. Fantastic little game. Well, not little game. I remember I wasn't very fond of it when it was released, when I got it, because exactly the limitation in terms of time. Not in time, but time period. Which I find now, and actually years later after this was released, a very good thing. But yeah, that was too late. I no longer had it. Right, don't fall. And now, last, definitely not least. Come on, I had to say that, right? It is another game. It's time for the PC. I got the PlayStation 1 version few months ago, last year sometime. Although the original time I used to have this game was for the PC. Unfortunately, I lost the disc. Anyway, here's the game. Dark Light Conflict. This is a space shooter in let's say Wing Commander. With fantastic graphics at the time. I'm talking about graphics which, at least on the PC, you will feel like I'm speechless. They looked amazing. They looked absolutely stunning and didn't require a 3D graphics accelerator. Fantastic game. It has a good story. Very, I think you'll find the story quite similar to couple of very famous, well, not very famous, but science fiction movies. You, as a pilot, are abducted by an alien force and made and forced to fight for them because they are running out of people or something like that. I don't remember the exact details now. I have to say again, the graphics were amazing. And as a shooter, it's also very good. It starts okay, then gets quite difficult. I don't think I ever finished it. Not 100% sure though. Still, great game. If you find it, get it. Dark Light Conflict. Well worth the money. I didn't pay $34.99 you see here, because that's obviously an old price from when this one's new. Someone bought it then. I got it for like 7 or 8 euros, something like that. Fantastic. Yeah. And one more thing. Don't know if I can show you now. I'll try. Alright. Now this is definitely very different. This is a mouse pad, but I just had to have it. Strix. glide speed, gaming mousepad, unleash your gaming instincts. First time I buy a gamepad from Asus. I have their keyboard, the Strix keyboard, although I don't currently use it. I do have it. Very good keyboard. And yeah, I thought it looked fantastic, these colors in orange. And yeah. Anyway, that's it. I think I got it like for 5 euros. I don't remember. New, of course. Yeah. Thank you very much for watching. Bye-bye.